At 750,
70万那里。
At 750, there you go, sir.
可不可以再加2万？有没有再加两万？可以。
At 750 now. At 750, 20 if you like.
The bilingual auction has engaged a part of the market which has now become a significant part of the market, and that is particularly the Chinese but also the Indian community who are spending a significant amount of money here on property, and they find the bilingual approach is more engaging, they're more relaxed, and when they're more relaxed they're more inclined to spend more money.
820, first call.
8,000第一次.
With you, sir, if you like. I've got 820 here.
Actually, to be honest with you, I was quite impressed because I didn't realize that this does happen.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5. There you go, sir. That's 5 in Hindi, folks.
The bilingual, especially people who can't understand English. I mean, obviously in New Zealand, we expect everyone to understand English, but there are a lot of people from China coming in, and fortunately for them,if they cannot understand English, you have provided the platform to actually make them explain them in their own language.
At 905, second call.
95,500.
Come on now. At 945, the gentleman over here, 50.
95,000.
At 950, the money now.
In this market, we're expecting a lot of Chinese presence, and the ability to communicate with those buyers present in an auction gives us this very big advantage.
At $1,000,000, first call, 1,005,000. At 1,005,000, any further advances now? At 1,005,000, first call,
105,500.
We're going to say it's going, and it's sold.
It's always great to have an auction where the vendor and the purchaser are really happy with the result. The good thing about doing these sort of multicultural, bilingual auctions is that everybody gets to know exactly what's going on. Should you be looking to sell your property, we trust you'd be keen to use us as bilingual auctioneers. That's both Adam and myself, and thank you very much for your time.